So in this video, we're going to walk through how to find the area of your golf course. This is part of phase two. After you found the perimeter, you'll use another photocopy of your golf course. And if you don't have one, please ask Mr. T. And we're going to use this photocopy, and we're going to divvy up our golf course into areas that we can calculate the area of. So if you remember from section or chapter 9, section 3, in order to find the area of an irregular figure, meaning a figure that has multiple angles and shapes, the best way to do that is to divide it up into shapes that we have formulas for, or that we can calculate. So in this video, I'm going to walk through how to calculate a couple of them, and then I'll show you what the end product will look like. So to start off, I need to divide up my golf course into shapes. So to do that, I'm going to kind of use the boundaries to find shapes that I can easily measure. So my first one is going to be this box here. Now, I find it's really easy to color code. It makes it a lot easier to look back on your drawing and find out what shapes you made and where the shapes are. Okay, so there's my first square. So if I know that this side is, well, 1 plus 2 plus 1 would be 4. So I have a width of 4 and a length of 5. I know the area of a square or rectangle is length times width. So that'd be 4 times 5 equals 20 inches squared. Remember, each one of these squares is one square inch, or an inch by an inch. So that's one. Whew, we have a lot to go. Let's focus on an irregular shape. I'm going to use this big triangle down here. So, unlike the length times width, triangles are a little bit different. So the first thing I'm going to do is I am going to section off my triangle. Now, I find it's easy when you're finding the area of your golf course to start with the irregular shapes first. So that's what I'm going to do. So with my triangle, I'm going to make a box around my triangle, as if it were a square, as if the whole thing were playable, where the diagonal of the triangle cuts the box exactly in half. Using this, if I find the total area of the square, well, I just multiply 7 times 7. So the area of the square is equal to 7, the width, times 7. The length. That gives me 49 inches squared. Then, since I really only want the area of the triangle, or half the area of the square, I'm going to divide this in half. And 49 divided by 2 24 and a half. So the area of my triangle is 24 and a half. Now, if you wanted to use the formula for a triangle, which would be equals 1 half base times height, I would have 1 half. The base in this case, well, would be on the top or on the side. And that just means that the other side would be the height. And if you look, it'd be 7 times 7 divided by 2, you'd get the same exact thing as what you did here. So that is my area. And you can do the same thing with this triangle here. Now let's move on to the circles, because these are a little bit trickier. So the first thing I'm going to do is, well, I'll start with this little circle. I'm going to box off my circle so that it is completely enclosed by a box. As you're watching this video, feel free to click pause at any point and do this yourself on your own drawing. So, I boxed off my circle, and my box has side lengths of 1 and 1. So, my whole box has an area of length times width equals area. So it is 1 inch squared. So on my diagram, when I build it, that box will show as 1 inch squared. But I really don't care about the area of the circle. I want to find the tiny little corners that are on just on the edge of the circle. The way to do that is, well, it's a little bit of an extra step, but now I'm going to find the area of the circle. So, if you remember the formula for a circle, it is pi times the radius squared. So my radius is 1/2. 1/2 times 1/2 will give me 0.25, or 1/4. And if I multiply that by pi, so 1/4 times pi, my area of the circle is 0.79 inches squared. So I found the area of my circle, and I know the area of the whole box. So what do you think I should do now? Well, if you said subtract the area of the circle from the square, nice job. Give yourself a pat on the back. So we have our area of our corners is equal to the area of our square minus the area of our circle. And if we subtract 0.79 from 1, we get the area of those corners to equal 0.21 inches squared. All right. Whew. So we got that one over with. Now we just have one circle left. So let's take a look at this one. We're going to do the same exact thing as we did with that circle, except for this time we're working with a half circle. Now I'm not going to do it completely out, because the steps are really similar to the one we just did. But now, instead of using a whole circle, like we did, we found the area of the whole circle, pi times the radius squared. We're just finding the area of the half circle. So we'll follow the same steps. We'll find the area of our square. So if this has side lengths 2.5, and this has a length of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm counting by twos because 2 is my scale factor. 2 boxes is 1 inch. So, start out. To get my area of the box, I'd multiply 2 times 5, or the length times the width. And then I would subtract the area of half the circle. So you'd find the area of the circle and divide it by 2, and then take that away from the total square. Now the rest of it, once you've done your irregular shapes, the rest is easy. Well, just time consuming. Once you've done it all out, yours should look something like this. You see here, I divided out my area into rectangles, as many rectangles as I could, because rectangles are the easiest. It's just the length times the width. Here, I divided it in half, but I really didn't need to, so that just shows me that 32 inches squared is the area of this whole square. So, once you have it all sectioned out, you can add up all of the areas, subtract the ones that you need to, with circles, and traps, and hazards, and voila. That will give you your area, playable area, of your golf course. Now remember, the tee box is playable. If the ball rolls onto the tee box, you can still play it. Or, if the ball rolls into the pin, that's still playable, because that's, well, it's where you're trying to get the ball. So, hope this helps. If you have any questions, ask Mr. T. Thanks.